the interesting one that we used in our UOA, kind of talking about that from what John and Pete were talking about, we actually chose the spiders this week for our UOA essential class. And I think it's an interesting trade because looking at what the ETF is actually moving in terms of on a daily basis. So we're getting something like 550 of movement, but the options are relatively cheap, right? We know where we are in terms of implied volatility. I was talking about with Brian McCormick in the rapid fire chart. So we were really kind of getting into the ideas and concepts of, you know, why, how do you value an option, right? And again, you're not planning on holding this all the way to expiration. You're just trying to ride it for the wave, something we do in the pit every day, every given moment of the day. It's all about trying to, and again, I think we had a question come in about, you know, renting the option. That's really what we're trying to do. So again, as John mentioned, these zero DTE options are very, very lucrative because they are cheap, right? If you can get in on the right side of it, it doesn't have to be necessarily zero, but maybe 1, 2, or 3 days, right? We're getting into some very good movement and able to get into an option that's really relatively cheap based off the potential movement of the stock or the ETF. So that this week we did options, I think, on depending on which side you chose. You know, obviously we had a little bit of a sell on balance here at the close of the market here today, end of the quarter, or end of the month, I should say, sorry. But again, either on either side for this Friday, options were roughly $250, right? So for $2.50, you can play a $400 ETF and basically try to capture some of the ATR, which is the average true range, for roughly, you know, $5. So today's ATR on that one, we were looking at about $579. So right in line, I'm sorry, the true range today was only about $3.30 on a $5.79 ATR. So you got a couple bucks of movement, maybe a little bit more of a whipsaw because what we were going on in the market today and the sell-off at the end of the day. But yeah, I mean, in terms of that, I mean, that service alone, we did have Tesla because of what's going on. We had some ARK bonus names in there. We also had Mara, which I believe they postponed their, that's M-A-R-A. They postponed their announcement, their earnings per share announcement tonight and moved it out. So you can see on the chart, this was looking really, really strong at the beginning of the day and they slammed into that thing. So not a good sign when a company says, yeah, we got to postpone this for a week or two. We're not ready. Or I didn't see any details on that. So that's going to be one for UOA. Other services, coming back to that Rebel Weekly you mentioned, you know, talk about some of the discipline there. I can kind of mention the one of the trades that we had in there that really has not gotten in terms of discipline. And it really does come back to this was a bear trade for us. This, we started Rebel Weekly yesterday. How that comes out, that's basically a one video for the week. It's giving you a bull trade and a bear trade. And the idea behind that is we're going to find ones that have a lean to one side or the other. So in terms of this one, we had said, hey, look, if this thing starts to get down below the low of Tuesday, at the time was 89.34, and we opened on that level. I think we traded down to a low of 89.32. So again, using the discipline, we're going to make sure that we're down below that level. And you can see pretty much it traded up on the day. So we would not have jumped into that put. So I think as Monty was saying, basically it's about getting in and getting out is terms of the discipline. So there's just a couple of quick examples for you.